LU-R1 started as an idea of how could we partner strong sciences in the liberal arts context with research being done at leading research universities in the United States. Clearly, the most convenient bridge was our alumni. So the first step was to explore which of our alumni were leading research laboratories in R1 universities. The next step was to see if our undergraduate students might be interested in research opportunities for the summer. Was there enough demand to satisfy both the work here in the Lawrence labs and work that we could secure for them in R1 laboratories? The answer from the students was yes.
So many of the alums have reached a stage in their life where they're excited about giving back to the college in some way. It's an attempt to bring the alums into a mentoring role with our undergraduates as they go on into various parts of science.
I'm really into science, like hugely into science. To think that someone who had a real passion for research as an undergraduate and knew that, to give them this opportunity is just really incredible.
I have spent more than 25 years studying at the Complex Carbohydrate Research Center, and I chose to be here because it's the best place, I think, in the world to study complex carbohydrates. So what do I do on a day-to-day basis? I study the biochemistry and the molecular biology and the biology of how these carbohydrates are made, what their structure is, and how they're useful for the plant and how they're useful to us.
Deb Monin is a very prominent plant biochemist. She's spearheading the collaboration of a number of other scientists interested in the same kind of thing on a $147 million grant, does fascinating research.
I've been interested in maybe pursuing a graduate degree in the field of biology and maybe becoming a researcher myself. And it's nice to have an experience outside of Lawrence in a different institution and see how things work when you don't know what the result is going to be and you really have to put on your thinking cap and wonder what's going to happen.
The project Joe's been working on and that I've been working on for a while grew out of my interest that I got in graduate school. I was studying essentially tumors in plants as a graduate student. Although I must say, for the record, that my first experiment with agrobacterium was in Nick Miravolo's botany class in 19, I forget when.
It was probably around the lunchroom.
Hi, Nick. And that certainly came out of my time at Lawrence. I recall very vividly, you know, spending hours and hours in the lab doing experiments on plant growth control. And that led me, as a graduate student, into plant tumors, which then led me to agrobacterium, which led me here.
Dr. Binns is the provost at the University of Pennsylvania, very busy man, and he's found time to spend daily with Joe. Joe said he's been very helpful, comes in, talks with him about planning experiments, talks with him about life. This is a very distinguished scientist who's doing groundbreaking work.
My responsibilities have been pretty varied throughout the summer. I've gotten to work in the greenhouse producing a brand new database for all of our over 2,000 plants. It's always important to see that what you do somewhere, the way you practice something, the way I, you know, do things in lab classes at school, it's always important to know that those skills, A, you're doing them well, B, you can translate into other areas. Like, I can take what I've learned at school and really use it. Once I got over the initial nervousness of being in a new lab, that I could really, not necessarily hold my own, but I wasn't lost, which was good.
Grace, she is such a deep thinker. She came in, and this was so funny. She came in on a Thursday or Friday, I forget, and I just said, okay, sometime early next week, please have read these papers and considered this general questionnaire. And it was a tough question. And I expected her to kind of scratch the surface, right? She worked the whole weekend, you know, just getting into the city, hardly getting her feet wet, and she was going to put her nose to the grindstone, which she did. And I think it was Monday, she came back with this amazing paper. And to have that type of dedication and the seriousness with which she approached this, and yet also having a wonderful attitude and enjoying it, was quite remarkable and certainly contributed to the project.
I'm involved with the various experiments of all the research associates and Dr. Binns himself. So you get to hear a lot of different types of scientists talk about interesting and new findings, you know, things that aren't written down in your textbook. They're things that are brand new. So I get to sit in and listen and participate in these discussions, which is really a new thing for me.
I will go back to school with a tremendous amount of respect for anyone who does research, especially with bioenergy. Not only is it important, it's something that our generation can hopefully, you know, finish up or get moving, whichever way you want to look at it.
One of the objectives is to have these students bring these projects back to campus, excite the other students and the faculty, bring new techniques, new approaches. I've heard very, very positive things from the students, but they also say that they've learned a lot of things about themselves. Living in new settings, working with new people, learning about life and the potential personally that they had that they never really appreciated before.
Joe's been working on two major projects. He's been the one doing all the microscopy, all the bacterial cell culture, getting stuff ready for those experiments, then putting the data into useful form. Joe came in ready to go. It was clear some of the technical things he had to learn, and he learned them very quickly. And he has read and thought, so I would say that's very good.
I think Grace will have a better idea or more of an idea or an additional idea of what research is like if you're interested in going the track of having a career in research. I hope I get the opportunity to do this again. I wish all Laurentians just the best. It's a great school, and we have there are a lot of challenges ahead, so we need the minds that Lawrence is going to train.
There's so many things I can take out of this. How much work and how much, you know, independent study goes into everything like that, and which isn't necessarily something I would have known had I not had an opportunity like this.
The LU-R1 program allowed me to find out what science is really like outside of Lawrence University, allowed me to explore my strengths and weaknesses as a scientist, and also allowed me to discover a new city and discover my place in a new city too.